It's time for the match game. Hollywood Square. Our with Fanny Fly. From Hill Street Blues, James B. Sicking. Lois Hamilton. From We've Got It Made, Tom Villar. Leonard Troy. And the stars of the match game, Hollywood Squares, are Gene Rayburn and John Bowman.
Thank you very much.
Wow!
I tell you, you're absolutely right. These are wonderful people, and you were right to applaud them as briskly as you did. How is everyone today?
Just wonderful.
Okay,
how are you?
Jim?
I'm barely here, you know.
Why? What happened?
I sprained my ankle. My son and I were playing one-on-one basketball this morning, and I beat him, though, but...
You did.
Oh, was, what a cost.
Too competitive. Well, it's not going to affect your brain here today, because this is very...
No, that's where my brain is.
Oh, I see, in your ankle. It's a terrific intellectual exercise to do this show, as you well know.
Sprain your brain.
Anybody have anything to plug or say or do or Tom? Anything on your little mind there?
No, it's wide open and raring to go.
I'm anxious to get on with the game.
Well, then let's do that by greeting our two players over here, Lou Anderson and Sue Sward. Welcome. Let's get acquainted. First, we're going to find out about Lou. Tell us about you, please.
I'm originally from South Africa, but I've lived most of my life in Southern California. At the moment, we're moving from Laguna Beach to L.A. That's a big part of our lives right now. I love to travel and love to do something like this.
All right. We'll do it in a minute. Sue, tell us about you, please.
I'm a recent graduate of San Diego State University, and I live in San Diego, and I'm a waitress, and I do volunteer work at a hospital.
Good for you. All right, good luck to both of you. We'll play the match game, and the winner at the end of the third round will go on to challenge our returning champion on Hollywood Squares for a chance to win up to $30,000. Now, Lou, you won the toss, so you'll go first.
B, please.
You want B?
I think.
You sure?
I hope.
B, that's this
good
one right
choice.
Here it is. Ethel said.
Yeah.
Ethel?
Ethel is speaking, and she said, "My husband, the butcher, treats me like a piece of meat."
Oh, no.
Yes. That's what she said. Last night, he tried to blank me. My husband, the butcher. The butcher.
The butcher.
And how butch is he?
Oh, I don't know. Won't we get letters?
No.
We won't get letters?
All right, Lou, ready? Ethel said, "My husband, the butcher, treats me like a piece of meat. Last night he tried to blank me."
Hang me.
Hang me. All right, they hang meat to age it and make it tender.
Oh, come on.
That's one thing. That's a very original and interesting answer, because the butchers do indeed hang meat to make it tender and age it. That's right. Aged beef is hung beef. Okay, Jim.
I was going to say smoke, but I ended up with trim.
Trim. A butcher does trim a piece of meat. Fanny, what did you say?
I don't know any butchers.
You don't know any butchers?
No, and I was kind of at a loss, so I said, chop me up.
Chop me up, all right? That's something that butchers do. That's all right.
I don't know.
I really liked hang. I would have said that if I'd thought of it, but I said trim.
Trim is another thing that butchers do.
Oh, dear.
All right. John, what does a butcher do in your estimation?
I think the operative question here is, how butch is he? I said, cleave.
Cleave me.
Take no prisoners, Sean.
All right, Lois.
Well, being of Italian extraction, eating a lot of veal, we do a lot of beating.
Oh, that's right. You beat the veal. Go ahead.
Lois.
Beat me.
This is aged meat.
Aged meat.
Is it the butcher who gave you that steak? Say that it is, and you're dead. 40 points. Where's that from?
Say again.
Is it the butcher who gave you that steak? Say that it is and you're dead. Who do you love? A hope. Who do you need? A hope. Who is it going to be?
Annie, get
right.
your gun.
40 points.
Gene Wood, give her something.
Give her 40 points and a cleaver.
Give her something for that. That
she
was
can
great.
Have me to beat.
You got some money in your pocket? You have some money in your pocket? Give her some money.
Give her a pound of chopped beef.
No, give her some money. I don't want to ever have chopped beef. Have you got an answer, Leonard?
I have a ghoulish, terrible answer. Slice.
All right, that's something that butchers do.
That's what came to my head, too.
Oh, that was a hard one, wasn't it? All right, Sue, this one is for you. Gloria said, my boyfriend has no class. At the restaurant, he asked the waiter, what wine goes best with blank?
What next?
Everybody ready? Except Lois. Right, in the terrible. Slot. Here we go, Sue. Gloria said, my boyfriend has no class. At the restaurant, he asked the waiter, what wine goes best with blank?
The soup.
See,
I'm sorry.
That would be a logical question.
I know.
You could ask
I'm a logical
the waiter,
person.
What wine goes best with the soup, and there would be nothing wrong with that if you wanted a little soup with your wine. What did you say?
I said milk.
What wine goes best with milk?
Anything boring.
Oh, come
no.
on.
Hey, he has no class.
Grow up.
Anything goofy here, you know, like... The first thing that came to mind, well, I'll tell you later. Let's see if it comes up here. Fanny?
Well, I just thought what wine would go best with a hamburger.
Hamburger's a good one. Mine was in that category. What wine goes best with Frankfurters or hot dogs? That's yeah. what I said. Hello,
Very
Tom.
Good. Hi, how are you doing, Jim?
Good, how are you?
I'm ready here.
You are?
I said peanut butter and jelly sandwich.
Very good.
Very good.
Yeah, anything crazy like that. Where you would normally not drink wine, right, John?
What wine goes best with Coke?
Okay, there's another one.
Ah! Pain, I love it.
Lois?
Maybe I don't have a pedestrian mind. I said bread.
Bread. Bread and wine. All right.
You know what would have been great that just occurred to me that would really... Chow mein.
What yes. wine goes best with chow mein?
Wouldn't that
yes.
be sort of...
Right.
This is dumb. Waiter, what wine goes best with a glass of water?
That's dumb, right?
This is so arbitrary.
Oh, boy. So, ladies, we have a zip-to-zip score here at the end of round one. We'll go to round two right after this.
Concentrate.
Why are so many people...
Call 1-800-730-8860 or visit superbeatsdeal.com. That's 1-800-730-8860.
Here we go with round two. Now, since the score is tied 0-0 and she went first last time, Sue will ask you to go first this time.
I'll take B, please.
B. I hope you do better than she did last time.
B.
Sue drew a blank last time. Sue, the waitress, couldn't think of what goes good with wine.
This word?
Yes. Ida is so fat.
Ida?
You are ready. When she went swimming next to the love boat, the captain yelled, blank ho! That's all right. All right. We're all ready, Sue. Here it is. Ida is so fat. When she went swimming next to the love boat, the captain yelled, blank ho!
Land ho.
Land ho. All right. Let's see if that happens over here. Land ho is her answer, James.
Land ho. Land ho.
Land ho. One for Sue.
Yeah. I've lost my mind here. Now, this person was supposed to be fat, right?
Yes.
And
Ida
so the captain
so fat.
And she went swimming beside the love boat.
Right.
Yes.
Yes.
All right. And so the captain looked at. Why would he say land ho?
Because she was like big. She looked like a land mass.
You're in the center square.
I'm in the center square. Well, I thought she looked. I said whale ho.
Whale ho's all right.
See,
whale ho.
There she blows.
There she blows. But whale ho, you know, someone... See, the Love Boat people, they're really not sailors.
We know that. We were on the Love Boat. Right. We never left Burbank.
We co-starred in a Love Boat.
I know it.
One of the few funny ones they've ever done. May I canvass you for your answer, sir?
Well, I was going to say land, and so I did.
You did say that. All right, that's two for two. And let's see what we get from John. The captain yelled land ho.
Well, had we been in Hawaii, I think I would have said Don. But I said whale.
Whale ho.
The second best answer. That's the second best answer.
All right. Miss Lois, honey.
Deal.
Original.
Land ho. All right. Brava, brava.
Grazie, grazie. Grazie.
Buongiorno, giornali, giornali.
Is Hamilton Italian?
Basta.
No, she's a northern Italian lady.
I'm
Hamilton,
Italian.
Sure.
Yes. That's a stage name.
Oh.
Right. Don't we all? Leonard?
As Charles Nelson Reilly would say, the correct answer, of course, land.
All right. Three for two. Four. So, Lou, you've got a little catching up to do. Here it is.
Oh, I had that.
Sam said.
Sam.
Sam said, last night I drove through the toughest part of town. It was so tough. You're an eager bunch today, I tell you.
Determined lot.
You got them really riled up there, didn't you, you guys? I drove through the toughest part of town. It was so tough, even at 50 miles an hour, they stole my blank. All right, the lower tier is ready. Upper tier.
Tiers.
Lower tier is ready, upper tier.
Ta-da!
Ready.
All right, Lou. Sam said, last night I drove through the toughest part of town. It was so tough, even at 50 miles an hour, they stole my blank.
Tires.
Tires. That's one good possibility.
No.
Jim says no.
No.
Hubcaps.
That won't do.
What do you say?
Hubcaps.
Hubcaps you think is better than tires? Would you like to change?
I'm not sure.
Oh, well, in that case.
You're not allowed to. I was just teasing you for a second there, Lou. You've got to stick with tires. That's the first thing you said.
You ruined
what
that
you
routine.
Should have changed. Hubcaps.
Sorry?
Hubcaps.
Hubcaps.
I know she can't change her answer, but may I change mine?
No. All right. I'm so sorry.
Well, you never know. Who are the judges today?
Joe Newstein is over there.
I'll talk to you later. Unfortunately, I said hubcaps. I'm sorry.
Hubcaps is really a wonderful answer. Yeah.
Hubcaps.
Everybody up there said hubcaps. An excellent response. No doubt John has it.
I couldn't agree with you more. Hubcaps.
Right. Four of those so far, Lou. Lois?
Yeah, unequivocally. Hubcaps.
One tire. Oh, dear.
Hey!
We didn't do that to make it feel bad.
No.
Everybody said hubcap, so there it is. 4-0 at the end of round two, the third and final round right after this.
Settle down. Settle down. Who's first?
See who passed the whammy auditions on Press Your Luck. Weekdays at 4, only on Buzzer.
One car accident.
At 622-9516 or go online to trytagaway.com. Don't delay, order now.
Here we go. Third and final round. This is it. Sue, you're ahead. We ask you to go first.
A, please.
A, it is for you. Two people play, John and Fanny.
Okay.
While doing the dwarves' laundry, Snow White said, "There's something strange here. I have 6 pairs of jockey shorts and 1 blank." Okay. That's a good one. That's a good one. All right, here we go, Sue. While doing the dwarves' laundry, Snow White said, "There's something strange here. I have 6 pairs of jockey shorts and 1 blank."
Slip.
One slip?
Not bad.
We were thinking in terms of really...
Well, that's strange, don't you think?
It is strange, but something perhaps more related to jockey shorts. What do you say, Fanny?
Well, honey, Sneezy wore slips. Now, that wouldn't have been odd. But I say it was odd if they had one little bitty bra.
One little bitty bra. One bra, that would be strange. John, what was strange to you?
Well, one good slip deserves another, so I said a pair of panties.
That would be strange. Jockey shorts and panties, you see. That was.
So we both.
All right, Lou, you need 4 to tie and 5 to win. Little Harold said, "My father is really a weird parent. At Easter, he didn't give me a chocolate bunny. Instead, he gave me a blank bunny."
My father
is a really weird parent.
At Easter, he didn't give me a chocolate bunny. Instead, he gave me a... Okay.
All right, Tom. Here you go. Lou, last chance. Little Harold said my father is a really weird parent. At Easter, he didn't give me a chocolate bunny. Instead, he gave me a blank bunny.
Playboy
bunny.
What'd you say?
I love that one. What do you say to that, James?
I wish I had a daddy like that. Yes, Playboy.
Playboy Bunny. All right, 4-1 is the score.
Oh, God.
Need 3 more to tie it up. Fanny.
Well, I said he gave her a dead bunny.
That's weird.
That is weird.
I like that.
You like it?
My dad had one of the charter subscriptions to Playboy. When I was real little, that's what I used to look at.
Really?
Yeah.
You said Playboy.
Yeah.
Where was that, Tom? In New York?
Spencerport, New York. On the historic barge canal.
Oh, yes. That canal is still running, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay, let's see. Now, the score is 4-2, and she needs a couple more to tie, 3 to win.
4-3. Playboy.
All right. 4-3. Lois?
Playboy.
All right. Now we have a tie score, Leonard.
Oh.
Leonard, it's all up to you.
The pressure's on.
Lois, I did the wrong thing. Beat me, beat me!
Oh!
Aha! Uh-huh. Oh. Right on that red mark, if you would, please. Sue, it was a pleasure
Thank
to meet you.
You.
Gonna
nice
send
to meet
a
you.
Gift to you from the match game. Great. C. Sword,
Thanks.
Ladies and gentlemen. You came from behind and you won. Now we're going to switch to Hollywood Square to bring on 3 more celebrities. Here comes the rest of our furniture. I'll trade places with John. Lots more excitement coming along. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
A member of our studio audience will receive Quasar's 10-inch color television, ideal for the bedroom or kitchen. It offers a high-contrast picture, too. Customatic tuning and an earphone jack furnished by Quasar. It's time for more of The Match Game. Hollywood Square's Power with John Fame. From another world, Anna Stewart. And taking over, the star of the Hollywood Square, John Bowman.
Okay, we'll be right back with Hollywood Squares. Come with us.
Earn your degree from an affordable, respected state university that's made for you. No application fee if you apply by August 31st at umgc.edu.
Let's play.
And now, John Bowman and the Hollywood Square.
Hey, you. Welcome to the Hollywood Squares portion of the show. Congratulations to Lou Anderson, who, with the Playboy Bunny, made it through the match game. We have 3 brand-new celebrities. Anna Stewart. We have Carlo Imperato. And the glorious Nedra Voles. Hands off Carlo now, Nedra. Carlo.
Yes.
Carlo, who is one of the stars, they call him the kids from fame, but they're really the stars of fame. How long have you been doing this show now, and what age did you start?
Well, I've been doing the show for 3 years now. I started when I was 18, so now I'm 20. And I'll be doing it next year.
What? When did you start acting? How did you get?
I started acting when I was 13 years old. So I'm still a beginner, I guess.
Terrific. So right after your bar mitzvah, huh? Okay. Here we go, Lou. Let's go play Hollywood Squares. Carlos thinking about that one. Before we begin today's game, we must reacquaint ourselves with our Hollywood sailor champ. His name is Ron Astorello. He is returning with $2,525. Well, how do you feel about this so far? You still having a good time?
Excellent. It's the most fun I've ever had. It really is.
Uh-oh. You're sure about that?
Well, of course, I've been overseas.
Let me remind you about a few. No. Okay, well, you got at least one more day if you can get through. You haven't gotten into the big money yet, but who knows? Today could be your day. We're going to play this game until you hear the time's up bell, and then whoever is ahead goes on to play Supermatch. That could be worth up to $30,000. First game, $100. Ron, you get to start. Pick a star.
Fanny, please.
Fanny Flagg.
Ron, sweetheart, is this the most fun you've ever had?
Pretty close to it. Pretty close to it.
He's had a minute to think now.
That's right.
The most he can talk about it.
Fanny! Ooh.
Forget the game. What are you doing after this show? Because...
Well...
I mean, this man is in uniform, and we have duties to do, and I...
You don't mind if I interrupt just
for
a second?
Yes.
Please do.
We've been on this subject before today.
Yes.
Fanny, you have taken your dog on the Love Boat.
Yes, I did, as a matter of fact.
If he smells bad, can you wash him in the ocean? Or is salt water bad for your dog?
Actually, in a pinch. You know, I did work for that little dog. Got more mail than I did. I think truly, salt is neutralizes odor, so you can dip them in.
She says it's okay. You can wash them in the ocean. Agree or disagree for the first square, Ron?
I agree.
Salt water is bad for your dog. No, you should have disagreed. It leads to skin problems. Well, I shot that date for you, Fanny. Lou, it's your move. You're playing go.
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn.
Right.
You are an important business executive, and you like to impress people. According to Success Magazine, should you get a desk with lots of drawers in it? Or is it more impressive if you have no drawers at all?
Do you want me to answer it for you? I'll answer it for him.
With what you're wearing?
No drawers, no drawers. She married a man who had no drawers at all. That's my answer.
Okay, Gene, with that lovely song from Annie Get Your Gun, says that it's more impressive if you have no drawers at all in your desk.
I agree.
It is more impressive if you have no drawers at all. Yes, you are right to agree. You get the square. And you're off to a real good start, Ms. Anderson. Ron, not so good for you. You're playing X. Pick a star.
Nedra to block, please.
You missed You'd this better. One. The first game belongs to the challenger. Nedra Volz, you have just fallen into the water. And you can't swim.
Aww.
Is your pet gorilla a good enough swimmer to save you? Or can't he swim either?
Well, I don't hang out with gorillas, you see. I like orangutans better. But, yes, I think that he would probably make an effort to save me.
So you say he is a good enough swimmer to save you?
That's what I would say.
Mm-hmm. Agree or disagree, Ron, to block?
I disagree.
Your pet gorilla cannot swim either.
I
good
didn't
playing.
Know
you're
that.
Right to disagree. You get the square, and you do block. Yeah, you're in trouble.
I'm getting me another animal.
Ron, however, is not in trouble. He has blocked. Lou, you're playing go.
Anna, please.
Anna Stewart, from another world. Which of these is actually a summer camp for kids in Palm Beach, Florida, Anna? Is it the Emily Post Summer Camp for Etiquette or the Timothy Leary Camp for future space travelers.
Joe?
Oh, dear. Well, I would probably say the Emily Post, and heaven help them. That's what I would say, Emily Post.
Agree or disagree, Lou?
I'm going to agree.
It is the Emily Post Summer Camp. Yes, you were right to agree. You get the square. Sure, she's from another world. What does she know about the Timothy Leary Camp for future space travelers? We'll find out what happens in this $100 game right after these messages. Return with us.
Stay tuned for more of the Match Game Hollywood Squares Hour.
Fun. Excitement.
Go, Betty, go, 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 go.
Look at him fly.
Get the bonus!
Big deals.
A brand new car. Go to it. It's yours.
Big wins.
Bet it all that is higher. Oh!
And bigger laughs.
Who lives longer, the average game show host or a carp?
Whatever you want, there's a game show for that.
Buried treasure.
You get it.
And buzzers got it.
All right.
Weeknights starting at 8.
Are you older and need a helping hand?
June's Journey. Download now for free.
Now back to John Ballman and the Hollywood Square.
Okay. It is 75 for the challenger, 25 for the champ. But we're still in the middle of the first game. Pick a star for an X, Ron.
James DeBlock.
Mm-hmm. You missed this one, the game goes to the challenger. Oh. James B. Sicking. Your pet cat is neurotic. Is he more likely to drink alcohol than a normal cat? Or will all cats shy away from liquor?
He's neurotic. All right. This is an easy one because I have a cat that shies away from liquor, and my cat is neurotic.
Agree or disagree, Ron? To block.
I agree.
A neurotic cat will be more likely to drink.
No,
you should have disagreed with James. Your opponent gets the square and wins the first game. It's interesting. A neurotic cat is more likely to drink. Sure you don't find that interesting, Ron, at this moment, but pretty interesting. For you, Lou, you are ahead. $200 to 25, but we're going to clear the board, move right on to the next game. This one is worth $200, and you get to start. Ron Astorello, pick a star.
Fanny, please.
Fanny Flag.
Fanny, Fanny, Fanny.
Again.
From Annie, get your gun. Fanny. What weighs more, Fanny? Is it? What weighs more, Liberace's heaviest fur coat or an average wild chimpanzee?
An average wild chimpanzee is one of the options, and Liberace's fur coat. I believe Leonard should have this. He's working with
Monty. No, but the question is Liberace in the fur coat?
Oh, is Liberace in the fur coat?
No, it's just his coat.
Is it a chimpanzee coat?
Okay. A wild chimpanzee. I'm going to say his coat.
Agree or disagree, Ron? She says Liberace's fur coat weighs more.
I disagree.
Liberace's fur coat weighs more. No, you should have agreed with Fanny. Your opponent gets the first square in this game. Almost 140 pounds, Liberace's fur coat.
What kind of fur is it?
It's a lot of dead
chimpanzee fur.
How furry is it? Lou Anderson, it's your move. You're playing, though. You got one up there.
Leonard.
Leonard Fry.
Oh, this coat's so heavy, I can't play the piano.
Leonard, this song received the lowest rating ever on American Bandstand. Was it The Chipmunk Song by David Seville or Feelings by Morris Albert?
Right up your alley, Leonard.
Sing for it.
Feelings. Now that I was really try to forget my caps.
It was
feeling.
Agree or disagree, Lou?
American Bandstand, right?
Yeah, lowest rating ever on American Bandstand. He says it's Feelings.
I'll agree.
It was The Chipmunk Song. No, you should have disagreed with
Chipmunks
Leonard. Your opponent gets that square.
Climbing up my chimney.
Ron, pick a star.
Anna, please.
Anna Stewart. Is it okay to feed pork to your puppy, or should you keep him away from pig parts? Not to change the subject.
Oh, gosh. Well, I don't eat pork, and I would not feed it to my dog. However, I think it's okay. I think it's okay.
It's okay to feed pork to your puppy. Agree or disagree, Ron?
I disagree.
You should keep your puppy away from pig parts. That's why you're the champ. You get the square. Took that right out. Attaboy. Lou Anderson, he's tough. He's hanging in there. Whoa. Where'd you like to place an O?
Gene, please.
Gene Rayburn. Is a normal appendix closer in size to a worm or to an apple?
Ooh. A worm or an apple. A normal appendix.
A normal appendix, right. Could be a worm. Without Liberace in it.
Yeah. Well, an inflamed appendix is only about so big.
Gene, wait a minute. What kind of apple are you talking
like,
about?
I'm talking about a crab apple. A small apple is an inflamed appendix. So I would say a normal one would be closer to the size of a worm.
I agree.
That's okay. You do agree? It is closer in size to a worm. Yes, right. She's right on top of it. She gets the square, boy. Little thing can cause you a lot of trouble. All right, we're going to be back and complete the $200 game after these messages. It's exciting. It's close.
Whatever you want.
Bet it all that it's higher.
There's a game show for that.
Look at him fly.
And Buzzer's got it.
All right.
Weeknights starting at 8.
Thank you, the Friars Club. Okay, 250 to 75. And Ron, it's your move. You're playing X.
Nidra to block, please.
It's a pretty big lead for your opponent if you miss this one. Nidra Vols, in Hedrick, Iowa, the Hedrick High School basketball team has an unusual cheerleading squad. Are they all boys in skirts? Or are they all grandmothers?
Well, I'm from Iowa, but I don't really know where that little old town is. Where is that little Hendricks?
Hedrick, H-E-D-R-I-C-K.
That's funny. I thought
Iowa.
I lived in the smallest one. I don't know. Boys in skirts. Grandmothers, for heaven's sakes. Why not? Why not?
Agree or disagree, Ron, to block.
I agree.
They are all grandmothers. You are right to agree. You have the square and you do block. Rah, rah, rah. Attaboy. He stayed in it, Lou Anderson. Pick a star.
Carlo to block, please.
You missed this one, the game, and the lead goes to Ron. Carlo Imperato, you want to get into the Army. Do you need a high school diploma, or is that something they don't require?
No, you don't have to have a high school diploma. They'll accept you any way you are. They need whoever they can get.
He says you can be all that you can be without a high school diploma. Agree or disagree, Lou, to block.
I disagree. I should have agreed.
Well, I'll be the judge of that. You don't need a high school diploma. You're right. You should have agreed with Carlo. And your opponent gets that square and wins the game. No, you do not need a high school diploma to join the Army. But don't leave. Don't run off yet. You probably knew the answer to that. Clear the X's and O's off the board because we've got a very tight game going now. This one is worth $300. It's $325 to $250. Every 25 bucks counts. Lou, your move.
Fanny, please.
Fanny Flagg. Let's keep it going. She recently had her nose fixed, Fanny.
Yes.
And her breasts lifted.
Oh, I can tell you about 500.
I'll give you two choices.
Oh.
We'll narrow it down. Now she says she can't wait to have her thighs done. Is she Joan Collins or Joan Rivers?
Nose and breasts.
She's already
reduced?
Had her nose and breasts done. Now she can't wait to have her
when
thighs
you say
done.
Done, do you mean reduced or enlarged?
Those were her done. Her nose and her breasts were lifted. Now she can't wait to have her thighs done.
Done. I would say Joan Rivers.
Okay.
No.
Fanny definitively says Joan Rivers. Agree or disagree, Lou?
I'll agree.
You're right to agree. Oh. It's Joan Rivers. Well done. You get the square. Oh, shh. Ron, your move. You're playing X.
Gene, please.
Oh, shh. Gene Raper.
Gene.
What does Heloise suggest? Gene, what does Heloise suggest you do with old lint from the dryer? Do you roll it into fireplace logs or put it out for the birds?
Who suggests this?
Well, being a bird lover, I feed the birds in the wintertime in the east when I'm there because they have a hard time scratching for food when there's a lot of snow on the ground. But it's amazing how they will seek out any piece of cotton or stray piece of lint or anything like that. So it's a good idea to put it out for the birds.
Put that lint out for the birds, Ron. Agree or disagree?
I agree.
You should give it to the birds. Yes, you're right to agree. You get the square. Amazingly enough, they use the lint to build nests. Okay, creative recycling. Lou, where would you like to recycle an O?
Carlo, please. Try it again.
There's Gene sitting behind a desk without drawers, putting out things for birds.
Right. Carlo Imperato. According to Beyond the Male Myth, do most men enjoy hugging, kissing, and nothing more? Or do they think that's torture?
That's torture. Definitely torture.
This 21-year-old is certain that that's torture. Agree or disagree, Lou?
What age is this?
Well, really?
It's 1984 right now. No, no, it's most men, according to this book. Men of all ages.
No, I disagree.
According to the Beyond the Male Myth, most men enjoy it. You are right to disagree. Okay. You get the square. Okay. Very well done.
You can eat.
Good for you. Okay, that could be pivotal. Ron, pick a star for an X.
You can enjoy it, but then where does it lead to?
At least to Ron picking a place for an X.
Lois DeBlock, please.
Okay, you missed this one. The game belongs to Lou and the lead. Lois Hamilton, what part of your body is a bee most likely to sting?
Well.
Well, Gene, what do you think?
Retract your gears, guys. Is it your bare feet or your bare face?
Well, it's obvious it's your bare feet. Obviously.
Agree or disagree to block, Ron?
I agree.
Sure.
It is your bare feet. You are right to agree, you get the square, and you do block. And that is because people often step on bees. The bell means the time is up. $375. He hung on and did it once again. Ron Oscarello, attaboy. Oh!
That was a tight game.
That was a tight game, yes. You're right. You've been in enough to know. You've been up there a couple of times. You know where to go. Join Gene Rayburn. Get sent for your shout at the big money. Good going.
Thank you.
Ah! Echoing the feelings of Lou Anderson. Ah! That was a tight game. He got the lead, and he hung on just long enough to win. You played, obviously, very, very, very well. Both of you got most of the questions right, and you're leaving here with $300. Lou Anderson, congratulations and thanks. Gene Rayburn, take it away.
John, congratulations to Ron. We'll be back with Ron and our 9 stars and a go at the big money right after this. Well done.
My shift is done, but not my day.
Fun. Excitement.
Go, Betty, go.
Look at him fly.
Get the bonus!
Big deals.
A brand new car. Go to it. It's yours.
Big wins.
Bet it all that it's higher.
And bigger laughs.
Who lives longer, the average game show host or a carp?
Whatever you want, there's a game show for that.
Buried treasure.
You get it.
And buzzers got it.
Right.
Coming up next.
And now, here to play the super match is Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, Gene Wood. Here we go. Thank you. I know you're all rooting for Ron to win the big money, the $30,000. All right, Ron, let's have a go at it and see how much you will win here. We polled a recent studio audience and we said, write down your best answer to this. Key blank. If you give us the answer they gave most often, you get $1,000. For the second most popular, $500, and $250 for the third. Now, you may enlist the aid of any 3 of our 9 stars here for suggestions. Whom do you call on first?
Tom.
I think West.
K.
Key West.
Key West is his.
Carlo?
Carlo?
Key Largo.
Key Largo?
Anna.
Key Largo.
Oh, he said Key Largo.
Oh, he just talked to something.
There's an echo on the top row.
Key Money. Key Money. Key Money. Key Money.
Key Money.
No. That's New York. Key Money.
That's so now you have three answers given to you by the stars there. Key West, Key Largo, and Key Money. Now you have to think this over and decide whether you want one of those or whether you want, you think there's something better than that that might be up on that board. What would you like to do here, Ron?
Well, no offense to the stars, but I think Key Chain.
Yeah.
Key Chain.
Yes.
Sounds good to me. Let's find out if it's up there. No, they're not offended by that. Don't worry about it. He says Key Chain is what he wants. Let's take a look down at the bottom there and see what we've got under the $250 response. Key Largo. Okay, that was Carlo's answer. Now, the $500 response says Keyhole.
Oh, I said that.
Keyhole. You thought of that, right?
Applause.
All right, that's the $500 one. Now, Ron is hoping that Key Chain is going to be under the big one. Okay, Steve, slide it.
Yeah!
All right, now you've got the $1,000. That means $1,000 is yours in any case, irrevocably yours. Now it's time for the head-to-head match with any star of your choosing. And after you've made your decision, that star will reveal a hidden number, a 10, a 20, and 130 up there, and will multiply the $1,000 by whatever number is revealed. Time now to choose a star, Ron.
Lois.
All right, Lois. You're going to write a response? Oh, wait a minute. Hold on. I'm sorry. We've got to reveal a hidden number first. I'm getting ahead of myself here. Ready, set, go. $20,000 is what you're playing for.
Will you take 20?
$20,000. Here we go. No help from the audience, please, because if we hear an answer, we'll have to throw out the thing and start all over. Pittsburgh blank. Pittsburgh blank. Are you finished, Lois? Well, I'm sorry. When you have finished, put it in the slot and we'll call on Ron. Okay, now she's ready, Ron. You collect the $20,000. If you match Lois Hamilton, what do you put in that blank?
Steelers.
Pittsburgh Steelers. Steelers for $20,000. What are you laughing at?
It's not easy being a blonde. Just want you to know. Well, did we reveal?
Yes.
I had an absent father, no brothers. What do I know?
Pittsburgh Pirates. All right.
Baseball.
Steelers and Pirates were both good. Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania would have been it. All right. Pittsburgh, PA, any of those. All right, how much does Ron have? $3,900. That's not bad. And he'll be back tomorrow to play another game. But we'll be back in a minute with Ron and our stars right after this.
This is a paid advertisement for the Sheldon Law Group.
Here we go now to reveal the big 3-0. Which of the stars had it? Ready? Would you all grab the tabs and give a yank? Ready, set, go! Anna Stewart had it.
Aha!
The big 30 up there.
The Timothy Leary School of Future Space Travelers, yes. Well, he said Steelers, but now he can go over and tackle Lois after the show.
Okay, good idea. Thank you, stars. We'll see you tomorrow. Gene Rayburn inviting you to join us tomorrow.
John Babin saying so long for the Match Game Hollywood Squares. See you.
A member of our studio audience will receive a Kelvinator continuous cleaning electric range. It's 30 inches wide, has two large and two standard size surface units. Automatic oven timer and clock furnished by Kelvinator. This is Gene Woods speaking for the Match Game, Hollywood Squares Hour. I'm Art Goodson. Television production.